It's awful. It's awful and it's senseless. And if we don't stop talking about the gunman, so if somebody took a gun and went in and shot a 6-year-old girl, why are we talking about that person? Why? I would love to see, and I'll give you a challenge, I would like to see CNN come out with a policy that said, moving forward, we're not going to talk about the gunman. What we're going to say is, a coward walked into a movie theater and started shooting people. He's apprehended. The coward's in jail. He will never see the light of day again. Let's move on to the victims. Never talk to him again. And I'll tell you the analysis I'll give you, the analogy. I'm not great with words right now, okay? It's not been my best week. Is if you think about it, you used to see people jump on the fields all the time. Everybody would cover it and everybody would laugh, right? The network said, we're not going to cover that anymore. When was the last time you saw somebody jump on a field? Now, that's completely different level, right? But there's a lot of reasons. We always say, why, and we never know why. But we got enough data. Let's start figuring out why. And I'll guarantee one of them is because they want to be on television. They want to be infamous. So we can stop it. We can't stop it. We can only get shot. CNN, Fox News, the major networks. Why don't you guys all come out with a policy that says, we're not going to show this again. We realize we made a mistake. But just so this never happens again, here's what we're going to do. That would be my challenge to you and to every network. And let's see who comes out with it first.
I think a start also is not using this person's name, which
I don't know
which
what
we're
it
not
is.
Doing and very consciously. And sadly, not everybody is following that policy. But I understand why you're saying that.
I read USA Today all the time because I travel and they drop it at my door, right? I can't read it because I got to rip the guy's face out of every time I look at the paper. So, you know.
What is the next step for you? I mean,
for me, it's to make sure this little girl gets taken care of and she heals. To make sure those little guys that are going to kill me, they're 17 and 16 and 17, they heal. Make sure my wife heals. And make sure the thousands and thousands of people who sending me emails because they knew Alex, at least know we appreciate their prayers. And then, I don't know, a lot of the victims feel the same way as I. Maybe it's time for us to rise up. Because if you guys don't do it, maybe we use the internet and we say, you show that, okay, whoever advertises next, we'll never buy your product. That'd do it. But I think we would be proactive. You guys should look at yourselves and say, we need to take some ownership. It's not just us. We're not the only reason, but let's fix our own house before we blame the gun lobby or whatever. I'm not saying they're right either. I'm not making any political comments.
I have such a focus on the survivors, on the victims.
Exactly.
The people
it should always be on the victims. Stop making them infamous. What else are they going to do? I saw the guy today.
It's also one of those horrible things that even years from now, people sometimes remember the name of the killer.
And one person who died in Tucson besides Gabby Gifford. No one can give me an answer. There was a girl from 9/11 who died. They made her, but nobody can remember her name, but you can still remember the face of that coward. Because that's the only word I'm going to use on television.
Well, listen, I appreciate you all being on and talking about Alex and helping people to get to know, because I think that's the most important thing, what we're trying to do right now.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Thanks. Thanks for your time.
And I wish you strength. Ryan, thank you very much.